Everyone, I hope you're all doing really well today. So I'm really excited to be showing you guys this video because it contains all of the stuff that I got in a swap with my friend who lives in England. Her name is Amanda McCleary and her channel name is the same as her name. It's just Amanda McCleary, and I'll put a link to her channel down below. This is our second swap that we've done together, and we've decided we're gonna do them kind of regularly, like maybe every 3 months or so. And she just sent me a lot of really cool stuff. I love to get these swaps from her, and they're so much fun because we mostly do drugstore items, and a lot of the items are things that we don't have in the drugstores here in the US, so it's a lot of stuff that I don't get to see and get to try out new products, British products, which is really fun for me, really, really cool. So she sent all of the things nicely packaged, and they were all so cute. So I had asked her to send me some things from MUA. MUA is sort of a really inexpensive company where they sell makeup in the drugstore in England, and I'd never tried their items, so I wanted her to pick some out for me that she had tried and loved. And so she sent me mostly a lot of eyeshadows from them, which was great because I think both of us are huge eyeshadow fanatics. So I'm going to show you those first. So she sent me a whole bunch of them. She sent me shade 8 Pearl, which is right here. It's a turquoise color, and it is very pigmented right there. Shade 28 Pearl, and this one is, this one's really pretty actually. This might be my favorite shade that she sent me. It is like a coppery shade. That's what it looks like in the container. Shade 29 Pearl, and I think from watching one of her videos, I think this green one might be one of her very favorites, if I remember correctly. It looks like this in the container. Shade 12 Pearl, which is a duochrome that reminds me of, here I actually have to swatch it out so you can see the duochrome. It's sort of a reddish brown lava color with a greenish kind of duochrome on top, like a greenish silver. Shade 3 Pearl, which is like a slate kind of color, and there it is right there on that finger. Hopefully the actual color shows up. I see it reflecting a lot off the sun, but that's what it looks like in the container. And I gotta go wipe my hands because I got way too much. So then from MUA, she sent me one blush, and I think that these are maybe like 1 pound, something like that. They're very cheap. And right here, it's in the color Cupcake, and it just looks like a very light pink shade. It's a little powdery, but I mean, for the price, it goes on really nicely. It probably doesn't even show up right there, but on my cheek there you can see it a lot better. On my cheeks, it's kind of like one of those colors that's really hard to overdo. You don't have to think too much about it. You just put it on and whatever. And I think for the price, it's a really nice color that a lot of people can wear and not have to worry about over applying or whatever with blush. And then she also sent me their lipstick shade 4. And so these MUA lipsticks, they actually come with a little thing at the bottom that has a little bit of lip gloss, which I think is super cool. I haven't actually tried the lip gloss yet, but the lipstick, it looks like this. It's just a light pink shade, and this is actually, it reminds me a lot more of like a tinted lip balm than a lipstick. It's just very subtle. And you can see, I rubbed back and forth like several times, and that's what it looks like. It's just pretty sheer, just a little shade of pink. And it feels very comfortable on the lips, very balmy. Intense Kisses High Intensity Gloss. And so it looks like this. This is the color Stolen Kisses. And it's just a super, it reminds me of a very holiday color, like a Christmassy color. A dark, intense, almost reddish pink color. And I tried that on, and it also felt really comfortable on my lips. It was a really nice, comfortable gloss to wear. And then she also sent me one of their big palettes, and I'm not sure how much these are, if they're like 5 pounds or what. I think they're something around equivalent to $5, I want to say. I want to say they're like half the price of whatever the sleek ones are, something like that. This is the one called Heaven and Earth, and they're pretty much just all neutral eyeshadows, and it comes with this little sponge tip applicator, and the sponge tip applicator is the nice kind of sponge tip applicator where it's more rubbery instead of the one that's like the meshy, like really cheap material. So I'm not going to swatch the whole thing for you here. I'll just do like a couple. I barely touched that. They're all very pigmented. And one thing that I will say is that the feel of a lot of them when you swatch them is almost like they're wet. Like they're just pressed loose dry eyeshadows, but they kind of feel wet almost in the same way that the L'Oreal Infallible ones are. That's the best way that I can describe it. I don't know if that is the reason why they are so pigmented and seem so nice for the price. I don't know if the reason why these companies use a formula like that is because it's cheaper, or maybe the United States, maybe FDA hasn't approved some ingredient that they're using, or I have no idea why, but that's just an interesting thing that I noticed from trying the eyeshadows of these two particular companies, and they both happen to be British companies, so I'm just curious as to why the eyeshadow formulas are so similar, and there's really nothing that I've tried like that in the United States. So I don't know, if you know the answer to that, you should let me know, because I'm kind of curious. So she also sent me one of her favorite nail colors, and this is called Jelly High Shine Nail Paint by Barry M, and it is the color Prickly Pear, and it is like a really, really pretty, let me see if I can show you, it's like a really, really pretty light purple color. It is so, so lovely. I'm gonna love that in the spring, and I actually requested it because I saw her wearing it in a video, and I asked her if she could send it to me in the swap, so I can't wait to wear that. It looks really opaque and really nice. I also requested from her to send me some of the L'Oreal Infallible eyeshadows. I found out recently that the shades that they have in England are almost entirely different than the shades that we have here in the United States, and I'm obsessed with these L'Oreal Infallible eyeshadows. I totally love them. So I asked specifically, I was like, oh my gosh, please send me this one called Bronze Divine, and I'm actually wearing it today. I sort of did like a little bit of a smoky-ish kind of an eye, and I used this as the main color for that, and it is, oh, I love this color. It looks so gorgeous with my skin tone, because I have a slightly warm skin tone, and my hair, the undertone of it is golden, and so this is like a, it's like a golden-y, I don't know, such an amazing color. It's like a golden, almost greenish tint, brownish bronzy color, and I just love it so much. Ugh, I love it. I've worn it a whole bunch of times since I got it. One called Sassy Marshmallow and one called Metallic Lilac. Sassy Marshmallow looks like this, and I actually wore it the other day when I was teaching, and one of my students who always comments on my makeup, she said it was her favorite ever and that I should wear it every day. So she wasn't a 6-year-old, she was actually an 11-year-old. And then Metallic Lilac is super pretty. It's not very lilac-y though. I would describe it more as like a purpley slate color, maybe just slightly purpley, bluish. There it is. But it's very pretty as well, and I've worn that. I wore that together actually with Sassy Marshmallow. Like, I wore this all over the lid, and I wore this like on the outer corner and in the crease. And then my sister actually went to England earlier this summer, and she got the collection Lasting Perfection Ultimate Wear Concealer for me. She had gotten me the shade, I think, Light 1, and it was close to my skin tone, but it was a little on the light side. I think I'll be able to wear it more in the winter, but I wanted the one that was maybe a little bit darker than that, or maybe one that I could mix to at least come up with my right skin tone. And so Amanda sent me Light 2, and I really love this. This is actually the perfect color for my skin tone, and it's just right there. One of the coolest things that she sent me that I really think is so cute, and I love little things, is by Look Beauty, which I think she told me was a pretty new company to them in Britain. And it came in this little thing right here. It's a palette. It's a palette, and it's so cute. It's so tiny. It's tinier than the Too Faced, the little travel ones that they have. I can't remember, Beauty to Go or something like that. The little ones that they have, this is tinier than that. It's so cute. It's like a really nice plastic material. This one is the shade Green Eyes, I believe. Yeah, Pretty Green Eyes is what it's called. And so you open it up, and there's a nice mirror there. There's 8 shadows. And then you just slide the bottom forward, and there's a really nice size blush, which is really pretty, and 4 lip glosses. So this one little tiny palette, the eyeshadows, really, they picked good eyeshadows. I mean, there's like a dark green, a dark purple, or a dark to medium purple. There's a champagne shimmery highlight shade. There's a dark brown, a matte brown for crease work. There is like a medium bronzy type shade. There's a light pink if you want that on your eyelid to do a look with, a light lilac, and a light silver. So lots of you know, pretty basic colors that you can do a lot of different looks with. And then the blush is actually really pigmented. Here, I just swatched it. It's super nice. I mean, it feels really, really nice actually, in terms of the feel of it, and I just swatched it with 2 fingers right there. And then all 3 of the lip products, I did swatch them just to see pigmentation. They're all really pigmented. I mean, like, I haven't actually used them as lip glosses, so I don't know how they feel on the lips, but they all seem really pigmented, and the fact that they're in a tiny little thing that you could easily stick in your purse, so cute. And I believe that these are pretty inexpensive. I don't know the price. Maybe Amanda will comment below and let us know how much they cost. But I just thought that was really cute. I love it, and I've been using it. I just think it's so super adorable. And so the final thing that she sent me is sort of like the crown jewel to me of the swap. I mean, there are other products that I really loved, but this is a little thing by Bourjois. And I asked her, she asked if I wanted to try maybe some things by Bourjois, and so I said yes. And so this was the thing she sent me by them, and oh my gosh, y'all, this makes me want to try everything in their line. It is the Bourjois, the Shine Edition Lip Shine. So it looks like this. It's in the cutest packaging. You see the color down below here. The color pigmentation is really great. Like, you see a lot of color, but you feel nothing on your lips. It just feels so light and so comfortable. And it's not sticky. Ugh, I love it. I want every single one that they make, and I want them all right now. So I'm sorry, you guys, if this video got a little long for you. She sent me a lot of things, and I wanted to tell you about all of them. So thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you so much, Amanda, for sending me all this stuff. I really appreciate it. I loved all your picks and really enjoyed opening it and getting to experience some of the British makeup from overseas. So thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you, Amanda, and I will talk to all of you guys again soon. Bye.